Hello everyone. Welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 221 to 240. This is the part 10 of top 300 MCQ of Indian Evidence Act. These videos are very important for APO, PCSJ and any other examination who are belonging to law. Now starting here, question number 221. Examination in chief. Here very important word, examination in chief of a witness shall be by a party calling the witness, shall be by a party, adverse party here, calling witness. Second point here, adverse party, both A and B, and either A or B. So here answer is A. Examination of chief shall be by the party calling the witness. So the provision of this examinations, so provided in section 137 of Evidence Act. There are examination chief, cross examination, re-examination. Examination of chief conducted by the party who call a witness. Cross examination is conducted by the adverse party, and re-examination same by the party who call witness. So now question number 222. Re-examination of witness shall be by a party calling the witness, shall be by the party, adverse party, both A and B, either A or B. So here answer is shall be by calling of witness, re-examination. Question number 223. The re-examination of witness can be done after examination in chief, but before cross-examination is not. It is wrong. After examination of chief and after cross-examination, yes, it is possible here. Either A or B, neither A nor B. So here answer is option B is correct. After the examination in chief and after cross-examination, the re-examination is held after examination in chief or cross-examination. Question number 224. The cross-examination of witness must be related to a relevant fact, less to be the confined to what the witness testify in examination chief. Must be related to a relevant fact, but need not to confine what the witness testify in examination chief. Not be related to relevant, not possible. And option D, may not be relate to a relevant fact. So it is not possible here. Both option not here. So option B is correct here. Must be related to relevant fact, but need not to confined to what the witness testify in examination in chief. Need not confined. And in option A there, the has to be confined. That is the reason. Correct answer is here B. Question number 225. The re-examination of witness can be for the purpose of filling what is left over in examination chief, can be for a purpose of explaining the matter referred in cross-examination. Yes, here it is correct answer here. The re-examination of witness can be for the purpose of explaining the matter referred in cross-examination. So, question number 226. After re-examination of witness, the adverse party has right to further cross-examination. The witness afresh in journal has no right to further cross-examination. The witness right to further cross-examination the witness only when a new matter is introduced in the re-examination, either A or B. So here answer is option C is correct here. Right the further cross-examination only when new matter is introduced in re-examination. Question number 226. The during re-examination of witness, A new matter can be introduced as the matter of right generally. A new matter can be introduced only when a permission of court. No new matter can be introduced at all, either A or C. So here answer is option B is correct here. A new matter can be introduced only with the permission of court. During re-examination of witness, the new matter can be introduced only with the permission of court. Question number 228. A co-defendant in a case cannot be cross-examined by another co-defendant under any circumstance. Can be cross-examined by another co-defendant if their interests are identical. Can be cross-examined by another co-defendant when their interest adverse to each other, and can be cross-examined by another co-defendant as a matter of right. So here question is, a co-defendant in case. So option A, under any circumstance their interests are identical. So option C here, interest adverse to each other. So option C is correct here. Can be cross-examined by another co-defendant when their interest adverse. Yes, this is very important point here. Adverse to each other. Question number. Question number 229. The leading question can be asked during cross-examination, examination chief, re-examination, all of the above. So leading questions are always asked in cross-examination without permission of court. It may be asked in examination chief, but only with the permission of court. What is the leading question? This is very important point. Leading question. The leading question are a question which suggesting the answer. If anybody asks to you, are you going to Agra? So this question suggesting the answer also, and the question the answer is given only in yes or no. So such type of question are leading question. The leading question, the provision of leading question is provided in section 141 of Evidence Act. Okay, question number 230. The court can permit a leading question during the examination in chief or re-examination if they are referred to a matter which are introductory, if they are referred to matter which are undisputed, if they are referred to a matter which are sufficiently proved, if they refer to either A, B, C. So here answer is option D is correct. If they are either A, B, C, D, matter which are introductory, matter which are undisputed, and matter which are sufficiently proved, the court can permit in this condition. Question number 231. A leading question has been defined as the question suggesting the answer. Yes, this is very important here. Question suggesting answer. It is leading question. Which are a person putting it, wish or expect to receive under section 40, 41, 140, 142, and 143. So here answer is 141. The 141 provided the provision of leading question. Question number 132. During the examination in chief or re-examination, the leading question cannot be asked any circumstance. Leading question on certain matter can be asked without permission of court. Here, without permission. Leading question on certain matter can be asked only with the permission of court. D, A, and not B and C. So here answer is option D. I already expressed that leading question can be asked in examination in chief or re-examination only with the permission of court. Permission of court. Permission of court. And in cross examination, there is no need of permission of court to ask the leading question. Question number 233. Under section 145 of Evidence Act, the witness may be cross-examined as to previous statement in writing without proving the same and without showing the same to the witness. Yes, it is correct answer here. Under section 145 of Evidence Act, a witness can be cross-examined as the previous statement, the statement given by the same witness in previous matter. So such previous statement is without proving the same and without showing the same to the witness. Under section 145. Question number 134. Under section 145 of Evidence Act, the witness may be contradicted as the previous statement in writing without proving the same, without showing the same of witness. Without proving the same, but only after showing the same to the witness. After proving the same, maybe before showing the same to the witness. After proving the same, may same and showing the same to the witness. So section 145, provided that the provision, the cross examination as the statement in writing. So statement in writing. So in this question, the question asked here under section 145 of Evidence Act, witness may be contradict as the previous statement. So here answer is without proving same, but only after showing the same to the witness. So option B is correct here. Question number 235. The objection as to the admissibility of documents in evidence can be made at any stage during a trial, can be made at first opportunity when the document is tendered in evidence, can be arise for the first time in appeal, all of the above. So here answer is option B correct here. The objection as to admissibility of document in evidence can be made at first opportunity and when the document is tendered in evidence. Question number 236. A party person and who called the witness can be permitted to cross examine. Yes, the here important word is party who call, and it is cross examined by the a person who called the witness. The witness so called by him as provided under section 152, section 153, section 154, section 155. So here answer is section 154. It is also called a hostile witness. So in such type of condition, the question by a party to his own witness. So such type of witness is hostile witness, and the witness is not going to speak a truth before the court. Question number 237, section 162 of CRPC, control a section 157 of Evidence Act, control section 156 of Evidence Act, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here answer is control 157 of Evidence Act. So section 157 of Evidence Act provided that the former statement of witness may be proved to corroborate later testimony as to same fact. So it is also related to a section 32, dying declaration of a deceased person. Now question number 238, the court question can be put by virtue. The court question can be put by virtue. Under section 164 of Evidence Act, under section 165 of Evidence Act, under section 166 of Evidence Act, under section 167 of Evidence Act. So here answer is under section 165 of Evidence Act. The court can put a question by their virtue. So this is very important question, and this section is provided the provision, section 165, the judge has power to put a question or order production. The judge has power to put any question. So here question number 239, the court question under section 165 of Evidence Act can be put to any witness, any party, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here answer is option C is here, both A and B. So the court question under section 165 of Evidence Act can be put to any witness, any party of the suit. So here answer is both A and B. The same type of provision provided in section 311 of CRPC and order number 10, rule number 2, sub rule number 4 of CPC, and same type of order number 16, rule number 14 of CPC. So these are very important sections. Question number 140. This is the final question of this video. To an answer to a court question, the adverse party has a right to cross examination as a matter of right, has a right to cross examine only with the permission of court, and has no right to cross examine as with the cross examine the witness, either A or C. So your question here, to an answer to court question, the adverse party, so here answer is option B here, has a right to cross examine only with the permission of court. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button, and don't forget to subscribe our channel, and please share this video to your friends and many groups, WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter. Thank you for watching.